Hello again. So for this Sunday's photo manipulation that's going on my blog, I am taking this goldfish and an orange, and I'm going to merge them and make it colorful and make it something different. Right now I'm doing the same old using the I don't think I use the lasso tool. I think I just selected the background, like, because it was mostly white, and then I went in with that little smart selection tool to go around the parts that I needed to take out of that selection, and then just use the mask. After this fish, you're gonna hopefully see the orange, where I did the same thing, and then I moved them over to the main layer. This is my main layer, which I added a gradient to, or blue background, and then a white gradient to kind of give it some flare. But I tried different colors, like I always do, to see what works. But yeah, this is gonna go through. Enjoy the music. Just know, all my tools that I mostly use when doing these is masks, like plenty of masks, brushes that I use mostly on the mask, and the selection tools, different ones, I try different ones, and everything else is just like effects that you add to each layer. But yeah, enjoy. And here, next, I'm going to be adding in some shadow. Just so you know, this part, I kind of, what I did is I laid down the fish layer with the mask, and then the orange layer with the mask, and then I duplicated the fish layer and drag it above the orange layer, so it's kind of sandwiched, the orange layer is sandwiched between the two fish layers. And then basically I just painted away on the mask the parts that I didn't want, and I kind of like changed the brush to like the opacity of it and the hardness of it, so like the head looks like it's part of the orange. And then I actually painted back in part of the scales on top. But yeah, I don't want to explain too much because it looks like it's like it takes away from the fun of it happening. And here is where I just took some, like a regular soft brush, and I put a layer behind the fish and just drew in, I changed the opacity of the brush, some light black shadow, kind of give it some dimension. But yeah, that's about it.
Thank you.
Okay, and forgive me here, but I started off trying to use this splash brush, but they weren't really high resolution, so I couldn't use them like I wanted to, because I kind of wanted to make like some splash on top fish look like it's underwater. I couldn't find a good photo to do that with, so yeah, what you're gonna see me do next is just another spin. Like, I didn't want to take a lot of time and like make water look like water, or make a regular brush look like water, or paint look like water. So yeah, I ended up just drawing out some lines, kind of giving it how can I say it, like a cartoonish type feel, like surrealism. But yeah, just wanted to drop that in there.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, so this is pretty much it. I added my signature at the end, and this is another week of photo manipulation and me just sharpening my skills. And if you would like, you can go to www.taviarose.com on my blog and contact me if you want to work on something together, collab on art, or if you want to try out something and need some help. But thanks again. Have a good one.